Oh, hi, I didn't see you there. So, have you heard about Redwood? You wanna see what it can do? Let's go. Okay, we're gonna start in a terminal here, and we have a couple of prerequisites. We need node greater than version 12, and we need yarn greater than version 1.15. So we're good to go there. So now we're gonna create our app structure with the yarn create utility. So we're gonna say yarn create Redwood app, and then where we want it to go. So in this case, my home directory, I'm gonna say ./redwoodblog. And we're going to create a blog here in this tutorial walkthrough. It's probably not the best usage of the JAMstack because everything normally could just be statically generated and served super fast. But we felt most developers are kind of familiar with a blog and how it works. And it would be a good test of, you know, showing how to talk to a database, how to use an API, and then how to generate these final pages. So there we go. So that's installed. It went into ran yarn install in the target directory. So we'll go in there now. And it even gives us the first command to run here, yarn rw, shortcut for Redwood, yarn rw dev. And what that'll do is open up your browser to the home page. And by default, we kind of have a splash screen from Redwood here. Welcome to RedwoodJS. And it describes why you're seeing this page. And we'll talk about that more in a minute with the Redwood router. So let's go back to the terminal here. And I'll cancel this. We'll open this up in VS Code. It's sort of our preferred editor, just because it has a lot of extensions that makes working with JavaScript files nicer. And you'll see we even have some recommended extensions that come along with the Redwood app package. And you'll get this little pop-up down here in the corner letting you know to install those. I already have those installed, so I'll skip that part. And I won't bother going into this directory structure in detail yet. We'll sort of talk about it as we go and start building apps. One interesting thing to note is you're used to adding packages with yarn add. You can't really do this anymore because we are using something called a monorepo, where we have two separate apps inside one. So we have an API with its own package JSON, and then we have web with its own package JSON. So when you want to add one to one or the other, you'll say yarn workspace web add lodash. And now it knows to add it to the web package. Likewise, you could make this the API package. Okay, something to keep in mind for adding your own packages going forward. Okay, the first thing we're gonna do here is let me start up yarn dev again. And we'll keep that running. And then I'll split this and have another terminal here for running our commands. And you notice that's localhost 8910, if you need to remember it. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is make a page. Pages are sort of the entry points into your Redwood structure. We wrap React components in what we call a page. It's just another type of component, but it's sort of a top level entry point for a URL. So when you say, you know, mysite.com/hello world, generally there'll be a hello world page you go to first, and then the page sort of organizes those components. And we have some tools to make this easier. You don't have to write this boilerplate page structure every time yourself. We have these things called generators. So if you say yarn redwood generate, we want to generate a page. In this case, we're going to generate the home page. So we'll say home. And then we give it the route we want it to live at. We want it to live in the root, so we'll just say slash. And you'll see this will output a couple things here. It outputs homepage.test and then the actual home page. So if we go over here to web, and this is in src, pages, and there's home page. There's the actual component, and then the test file that goes with it. And you can see this is just a React functional component. Const home page returns a little bit of content here. And if we go back to our site, it will have reloaded for us. And there's a home page. And the other thing that did, you might have seen down here, it's an updating routes file. So now if we go to web source routes, we can see here what it did. So it added this route for us. Remember the slash page home slash. So that's the path. Here's the page, home page, right? That's the name of that component we created. The page component, home page. And then it'll give it, by default, it'll give it the name the same as the page itself. So since the name was home, or since the page name was home, it created the route, named route home. And we'll talk about named routes soon. And you can see here, if you change this, let's say home, and then we go back to our browser. Now this is a 404 because slash doesn't mean anything anymore. But if you go to slash home, you'd be back there. So let's change that back. Make sure we save this first. Okay. And let's create another page. Let's make a about page. Let's say yarn redwood, and we could just use the shortcut G for generate. And we want another page, and we'll just say about. This time we'll leave off the path, because Redwood will automatically infer that from the name, and you'll see that it inferred the route itself from the name of the page. So we created the about page and it put it at slash about for us and also named it about. So if we go back to our browser and go to slash about, there's a new page. And no one's going to find that page, of course, just by typing in the URL. So let's make a link between the two. So we'll go to our home page and we're going to see our first import here. We're going to import link and routes from, and we'll get some hints here thanks to VS Code, RedwoodJS router. And now we'll say, instead of this paragraph tag, let's start a nav element. And this will be an unordered list of link. And two, where we want to go to is routes dot. And we here's where we use those named routes. So routes dot about, which is actually a function. And we'll say about, and that closes the link. And now if we go back to our browser, there's our about page, click about, flip back over to the about. Let's set a title on our page and we'll link that back to the home page. So if this is Redwood blog, then we can link that. And this is going to link to routes.home, right, which is our other named route. And we'll put this link over here. And then we'll do the same thing on the about page. Do that here, and we'll need to make sure we do our import. And now we're to our about page, we can go back to the home page. Great. But copying and pasting this was not the nicest thing in the world, right? We got this duplicated H1 link in both places. And let's say if we wanted a consistent nav, right, you'd probably also have the nav over here on the home and the about page. But now we have this big chunk of duplicated code in both spots, right? If you were going to have a consistent navigation, you'd have this navigation in all pages, the logo, and then our links. And then let's say here we had, this is the about page. And this is the home page. Now we've got all this duplicated code above this. The only thing these pages care about is what's actually in this paragraph tag. So this is where Redwood layouts come in. And a layout wraps a page with common HTML. So you have might have a header, might have a footer, might have a left nav. You don't want that duplicated in every single page. So that actually goes in a layout, and then a layout surrounds the page. Sort of looks like this. So your layout wraps the page, and then the pages will generally contain your components. So let's make that layout. Of course, we have a generator for that. So we're going to say yarn redwood generate layout. And this is a blog. So let's call this the blog layout. We just say blog. And now you see over here, if you go to layouts, you have a blog layout. And you got a test file as well. And you'll see as this is rendering it, so this is kind of where the magic happens. We're going to surround our page with layout. And then the children, which will be the actual content of the page, gets output here. So let's start using that. So let's go to the home page. And let's take out maybe all of this. We'll take out this. And then in the blog, we'll now return that instead. And then when that content went, that's where we're now going to have children. And then we'll need our imports, because now that's where our links are. So let's take them out of here and put this in blog layout. And then in the home page, now we'll use that layout. So we'll surround this with blog layout. And we need to import the blog layout itself. And you'll see we can just do SRC layouts. Blog layout. We don't need dot slash SRC or dot dot slash SRC. We sort of have these aliases. So if you're within the web workspace, you can just say SRC refers to web SRC, and then the same thing in API. So let's do this same thing on the about page. We'll replace all of this with this. This is the about page. And we don't need this import anymore. This is now going to be blog layout. And now we should see about and home. And those share the layout, of course, says all that shared code. And now these two pages only contain the content they care about, which is inside the layout here. All right, that's a good amount for this first step, I think. Next, let's actually start talking to the database and get a little more dynamic. See you over there.